Hello friends, in the previous video we have seen what is energy systems and chemical fuels. We have seen what is calorific value of a fuel, gross calorific value and net calorific value. In this video let us see how calorific value of a fuel is determined. The calorific value of a solid or liquid fuel is determined using Bohm's calorimeter. It is called Bohm's calorimetry. Similarly, the calorific value of gaseous fuel is determined using Boyle's calorimeter. So solid or liquid fuel calorific value is determined using Bohm's calorimeter, and for gaseous fuel Boyle's calorimeter is used. Now let us see how the calorific value of a solid or liquid fuel is determined using Bohm's calorimeter. So determination of calorific value of a solid fuel. As we know, calorific value is nothing but total amount of heat that is liberated when a unit mass of the fuel is completely burned in presence of oxygen. So we need to determine the amount of heat liberated by burning a known mass of the solid or liquid fuel. Now here a known mass of solid or liquid fuel is completely burned in the presence of oxygen in a bomb calorimeter. The heat liberated is absorbed by surrounding water and calorimeter. Thus the heat liberated by burning fuel is the heat gained by water and copper calorimeter. So using this principle we can determine the calorific value of a solid or liquid fuel. Now this is the bomb calorimeter used for the determination of calorific value of solid or liquid fuel. Now here you can see the copper calorimeter inside. Now this is the chamber. Now here we are placing the sample fuel, solid or liquid fuel is placed inside this copper chamber calorimeter. Now this is the sample of fuel, and the ignition wire is connected. So the ignition coil that you can see here. So it is used to produce fire. So when we supply current, so sample catches fire and it burns. Now this copper calorimeter is placed in a tank or a beaker containing water in it. This is water. So here we have stirrer connected in order to circulate the water for uniform temperature during the process. Now this is the thermometer to record the temperature of the water during the process. Now enough oxygen must be supplied inside. So there is oxygen lamps directly connected to that ignition chamber. So we can control the supply of oxygen. So required amount of oxygen or excess of oxygen is supplied here. So this is the sample placed in a crucible. Now this is called a steel bomb, or sometimes the copper bomb is used. Now there is jacket insulation outside this water. This is jacket insulation. So now this is covered like this. Now this is the stirrer. So after initially we have to weigh the known mass of the sample, that is fuel, liquid or solid fuel, and you have to place it inside this crucible, okay, known amount. So mass we have to record. So initial mass of the fuel we must record, and you have to place it inside. Then you have to seal it everything. Then it is placed in a beaker or a tank containing water. So volume of water and mass of water also must be recorded. Then you have to dip the temperature, and you have to note down that initial temperature of water. Then when the apparatus or setting is ready, you have to supply enough oxygen through this oxygen lens, and you have to allow this fuel to burn inside. So when we ignite, the fuel burns and it gives the carbon dioxide, oxygen plus heat. So whatever the heat that is produced, it's absorbed by this bomb, and that heat transferred to the water. As a result, the temperature of this water rises, so that we can record here. There is rise in temperature during the process, but because whatever the heat produced by burning is transferred here, so the water is continuously stirred, therefore we have uniform temperature throughout. So the temperature will rise, and at some point of time it will remain steady. So we have to note down the final steady temperature. After some time it may drop down. So the highest steady temperature we have to note down. So by knowing the mass of the fuel, then initial temperature, then final temperature, then mass of water present in this copper calorimeter, we can determine what is the calorific value of the solid or liquid fuel. In this method, we are measuring the gross calorific value. Why? Because the amount of heat produced is nothing but total amount. Whereas water that is liberated in the form of gas, it is converted back to liquid water by cooling. Therefore, it gets converted into a gross calorific value or high calorific value. Similarly, we can determine what is the net calorific value based on the calculation. Now here, let us see the calculation involved. Calculation to determine calorific value using bomb's calorimeter. So mass of the fuel is known. Mass of the fuel sample. So let us take it is equal to m gram. So initially you have to note down mass of the fuel. Then we know what is mass of water in the calorimeter. Mass of water in the calorimeter. Let us take it is as W1 grams. Then we know what is water equivalent of calorimeter. Calorimeter. These values are known. Water equivalent of calorimeter. Then there is stirrer. Then thermometer. Then bomb is equal to, let us say, W2 gram. Then we have initial temperature, T1 is equal to, let us take this one as T1 degree Celsius. Then final, this is initial, T initial, temperature final. Let us take this one as T2 degree Celsius. This is temperature, initial temperature and final temperature. So initial temperature. Now this is final temperature. Final temperature. So temperature of the external water after complete ignition of the fuel. Now calorific value of the fuel. So calorific value, calorific value, so is equal to the heat Q, calorie per gram or kilocalorie per kg. Now heat liberated by burning fuel, heat liberated by burning fuel is equal to M into Q, mass into Q. So heat absorbed by water and apparatus is equal to W1 plus W2 into T2, final temperature minus initial temperature. So here heat liberated by the fuel is equal to heat absorbed by water or apparatus, that is MQ is equal to W1 plus W2 into T2 minus T1, or Q is equal to W1 plus W2, W1 plus W2 into T2 minus T1, T2 minus T1 divided by M, calorie per gram or kilocalorie per kg, or Q is equal to W1 plus W2 into S into T2 minus T1 into S. S is nothing, specific heat of water divided by M, kg per kilojoule per kg, kilojoule per kg. So Q is equal to W1 plus W2 into T2 minus T1 into S divided by M. This is mass of fuel, kilojoule per kg, this is the SI unit. So S is nothing but specific heat of water. So specific heat in kilojoule per kg per degree Celsius. S is equal to specific heat. It is in kilojoule per kg per degree Celsius. So this is the high calorific value. So weight of mass of water in the calorimeter, then water equivalent of calorimeter into difference in temperature, then specific heat of water divided by M, kilojoule per kg, SI unit. So this is the calculation part for Bohm's calorimeter. So whatever the Q we have seen, it is gross calorific value. So that is equal to W1 plus W2 into delta T, that is T2 minus T1 into S divided by mass of fuel. So this much kilojoule per kg. So S is the specific heat of water, and this is T2 minus T1. Now this is the total weight. Now this is mass of fuel. Now net calorific value NCV is equal to GCV, that is gross calorific value, minus 0.09 into hydrogen percentage into latent heat of steam. Latent heat of steam. So this is the value. So we can determine what is the latent heat of steam. So how much water is formed? Sorry, we know it. What is the percentage of hydrogen? Then we know what is GCV value. By knowing that, we can determine. Or NCV is equal to gross calorific value minus 0.09 H into 587 calorie per gram. So latent heat of steam is 587 calorie per gram. So using these calculations, we can determine gross calorific value and net calorific value of a solid and liquid fuel using bomb calorimetry. So this is about a determination of calorific value using bomb calorimeter. Thank you.